Hudson Valley Knits Podcast. This is episode 83. I am Amy, and I am podcasting to you from the Hudson Valley in New York. I am Memers on Ravelry and Memers66 on Instagram and Twitter. I am currently in the same general area I podcast from last time, except that now I am on the trail that goes around the lake that I podcasted by last week or 2 weeks ago. I did the trail. I tried to do this last weekend, which was another beautiful weekend, and I ended up getting lost, and I didn't come off the trail when I should have, and I ended up going much farther than I should have, and it was a mess. So I learned my lesson. I researched it before I came out here instead of thinking I could figure it out by following the trail markers. So I ended up probably doing 12 to 14 miles last weekend, and I was slightly dehydrated because I only brought one bottle of water. So today I made sure I had extra water. I packed an extra sandwich, and I researched the map online before I came out here, and actually I met a hiker who actually gave me a printout copy of the map that he had an extra one of. So this is actually part of the Appalachian Trail, this little piece I'm on now. It runs through the Bear Mountain State Park, and if you've been watching me a while, if you see me podcast from the mountaintop called Anthony's Nose, sorry, there's lots of bugs. That's part of the Appalachian Trail too, but it's on the other side of the Hudson River. So the Appalachian Trail actually goes across the Hudson River, and most people walk across the Bear Mountain Bridge. So there's like not a soul in sight really for quite some time. And I just thought this was a nice place to stop and podcast. And I'm actually gonna just show you a couple of the things that I have going on, and then I'll walk a little more and maybe show you something else, and then maybe even when I get down to the lake again. I've already crested the mountain, and I should have done a little video clip up there, but I didn't. Sorry. So for WIPs, I concentrated mostly on one project this week, or these past 2 weeks, and that was the Apple Blossem Shawl. So I am going to show you my socks, but if you watched last week, there's no change. Here's the second sock for, you know what, I'm going to turn this around. Hold on. I think this is a little better. All right, so this is the second sock for my, calling them my lucky leprechaun socks. So here's the rainbow cuff, and let me just show you what the whole sock looks like because I finished the first one. And again, I apologize, no progress. I didn't work on these at all. I did Susan B. Anderson's. I used her instructions for this heel. It's afterthought heel, my first afterthought heel, and I did her tip for the smooth decreases, and I don't think it really made a difference. But anyway, I mean, I like it. I love the yarn. It is Never Enough Time sock yarn, and I think it's called the End of the Rainbow colorway. Wait a minute, I don't have the tag in here, but it's in my Jan Smiley bag with its canoes. The other sock, same deal. I have that with me, but I did not work on it. I did put it in a bigger bag. This is made out of Soxette Rock Lightweight and the Sea Scum Run colorway, which I really enjoy. And, oops, here's the band. Now, this pattern is by Alice Yu, and it's called the Kwalla. I can't remember. And I'm looking to see if it's on the Kwalla socks by Alice Yu. The pattern, I kind of said it might need some tweaking. Well, I think it needed way too much tweaking, but I still love it. And here it is so far. I'm on the foot part and I've got all my decreases done. I spoke about this last week, but I kind of did an extra gusset to get rid of all the extra stitches that I had since I was now doing stockinette on the bottom. And if I had kept to the stitch count she has in her pattern, it would have been swimming on my foot, which is not good. You know, if you pay for a pattern or you buy a book of patterns, the gauge should be adjusted so it's a good fit. I do have one new whip that I'll show you before I start back on the trail again. And this is exciting. So let me just explain. There is a, on the Fruity Knitting podcast, if you don't watch it, you should. It's a great podcast. Really, really professionally done. She is doing two cowls. One is a lace knitting garment cowl or half shawl cowl. You can do a half shawl or a knitted garment that involves lace. And she wants you to challenge yourself. And I'm just finishing the Apple Blossem shawl. So there's no, that was like a major lace project, so I'm not going to do another major lace project. But she also had a You and Me cowl, where you knit something for yourself and someone else. And originally I was not going to do it, but then I saw these new patterns come out from Quinson Company. And I was like, you know what, that would be quick and easy. And I could make a little something for myself and a little something for my daughter. So what I did is I picked for myself again, these are both Quinson Company patterns. This is Cullum by Isabele Kraemer. And it's a linen. It's knit in their finger weight linen, but I ordered Knit Picks for my sweater, which just came in the mail. It is Knit Picks Lindy chain, and it's a fingering weight 70% linen and 30% cotton. And it's like a navy blue. They don't have a color name on here, but it's like a nice, beautiful navy blue for myself. And I knit a piece, which is going to be like a cap. And it's gonna go, it's for the shoulder cap. Here's just a piece of it. I guess this is joined to the sweater later because she has you clip it off and put it on waist yarn. That's kind of what the fabric looks like. I've never knit with linen before. I found that I blocked it, and I found that it didn't make much difference in the softness. But from what I understand, the more you wear linen, the softer and more flowy it gets. Anyway, for Rachel, my daughter, who lives in Orlando, Florida, I decided to knit this pattern, which is Ripley by Leah B. Thibault. Isn't it beautiful? Now, I'm also using these two tanks for the Barry Shannon knit along. It's the TTT cal is the hashtag. T-shirts, tanks, and tops, I think it stands for. And so I'm gonna be in both cals. I'm not a cal person per se. By the way, I did order the Quinson Company yarn for this in the color Pebble. And the yarn, it's a bulky weight linen, 100% linen. Kestrel is the Quinson Company yarn. It should be here by Monday. So hopefully I'll have a lot more of this to show you. It's in another Jan Smiley bag, the frogs. And that's all I've got right here. The rest of my whips are in the car. Oh, I did bring my show notes. So I do have my show notes. I have some when I get down to the lake, maybe sooner, but probably when I get down to the lake, I'll stop again and I have some news to share with you, so about future cows and whatnot. So that's it for now. I'm gonna get back to hiking and I will see you in a little bit. So I'm off the Appalachian Trail now, and this is called Silvermine Lake Road. It's like, it's more like a fire road than anything, a dirt road. It's definitely not a road you could drive a car on, or a truck even for that matter, maybe like a four-wheel vehicle, off-road vehicle. And I'm not sure why it's here, because there is direct access to Silvermine from regular roads, but I guess perhaps park rangers come in through here, but this should take me to the lake now, if I am correct and following my map correct. I do know, based on my compass, that I am going in the right general direction, so hopefully we'll be at the lake soon. Alright, well, I made it to the lake in my hand. It was such a nice hike. There's the lake behind me. I think you might be able to see the parking lot in the back there. But, yeah. So just like another mile left to go. I'm on that road still, and then I'll be on Seven Lakes Drive, which is like a paved road, so easy going from here. I think I'm going to eat the rest of my lunch. It's 4 o'clock now, so I am kind of starving. Mark packed me a lunch, so I'm going to eat that. And then I'm going to find somewhere nice by that waterfall that I was at last week, and I'm going to do some outdoor knitting for a while. See ya. Hi, y'all. Taking a break down by the lake. It's actually behind the camera, so you can't see the beautiful lake, but I'm sitting right by the lakeside, and it was an amazing hike. So I think I explained it in the previous little clip. I am at Silvermine. It's same place I was at last podcast, and it's a beautiful lake, and I used to come here a lot when I was younger. And the ski club used to ski here. It's no longer skiing slopes, and then when I say ski slopes, they were just two very small, very easy slopes. I also, for a couple of years when I was in middle school, was part of the orienteering club. And that was kind of like mountaineering, where we would get a compass and a map and stuff. And we did that here. And I actually came here last week thinking I would do a hike around the lake. I was thinking there would be a trail that just went around the circumference of the lake. And I ended up going on a trail that kind of went up a mountain. And according to the map I had downloaded on my phone, it kind of should take you up the mountain and down and around the lake, and that's what I did today. But last week I ended up not taking a turn when I should have, and I ended up way out of my way and doubling up my miles, and I was in sad shape last week, and it was a lesson learned. And I'll tell you, if you're out hiking, and especially like me, it was a new to me trail, and even though I had done it when I was in middle school, it had been way too long, and I was way too confident about my skills following a map to think to bring a little extra water. I was hiking in an area that had no signal, so if anything happened to me, because I was alone, if anything happened to me, no one would find me. And the trail that I did tell my husband I would be on was, because of me getting lost, was the wrong one. So if something happened to me, I have a drop stitch, I would have ended up they would have had a hard time finding me. Anyway, all that said and done, from now on I will take extra water and extra. I took an extra sandwich today. But I did find my way, and I met a nice person, like I said, that gave me that map. So I made it fine, and it's so beautiful here. And it comes right back down to why I do this podcast. It's not just about the knitting. It's just something about being in the outdoors, and it's just so lovely and beautiful in the Hudson Valley that makes me appreciate all this and makes me want to podcast outside so that you could see my true loves, knitting and being outside in the Hudson Valley specifically. I can't tell you how many times I've gone on vacations. You know, you go on a vacation, you're like, oh, it's so beautiful here, I wish I lived here. And I used to do that, and then I think to myself, I live in a spot like that. So what am I thinking? I don't need to go anywhere. I just wanted to chit-chat a little bit about my knit-alongs and a craft-along that's going to be coming up. As you know, I am doing a goals contest this year that's very different than what I've done the past 2 years, where instead of having everyone post their goals for the year and then you achieve them, you get a chance to win kind of thing at the end of the year, I split it up into four quarters of the year. And the first quarter we had the homespun cowl, because one of my goals was to knit up, use up some of my homespun, which I actually still am going to do. I didn't bring the glam lamb with me. I showed it to you last week, but I didn't work on it the past 2 weeks, so I didn't bring it with me. But the sleeves of that, I will be using some bulky weight homespun I have in my stash. And that was always the plan, actually. I'm just not sure which one I'm going to use. Maybe I'll ask my daughter what she likes. And then the beginning of April, we started the second quarter, which is knitting up your whips. So I currently have the Apple Blossem Shawl, which is an old whip that I actually started working on before this month, but that's part of the whip, and that classifies, the Glam Lamb classifies, because I started that years ago. And as soon as I finish one of those, I'm going to pick up a Alice Starmore wrap that has been sitting in my closet hibernating for years, and try and finish that. So those are my plans for the whips part of this cowl. I'm using the same chat thread that we were using for the homespun, so please feel free to go to the Ravelry group, Hudson Valley Knits Ravelry group, and you'll see there's a chat thread, and I believe I did the finish object thread. If not, it will be there by the time I post this video. I am offering for a prize for the whips the Stephen West book, Best Knits, and it's volume one, which is shawls. And oh, I can't tell you how hard it was not to keep this, but I do have most of the patterns of the ones that I would really want to knit, all aside from one, and I talked about that last week. I think it's a brioche wrap. I definitely want to make that, but I'll have to buy the pattern when that time comes. What else? So that is my goals contest. Now, I haven't really talked much about the Senior Love Along this year. I do this every year, and I am doing it this year. I have not set up the threads yet because I found last year that there was no activity until like after the till summertime. So I'm not in any rush to put up the threads, but if you are wondering about the Senior Love Along, yes, I am doing that this year. And again, it's not just washcloths anymore. You can knit any kind of craft, any kind of gift that you want. As long as it's fairly small and you think a senior would love it, go for it. Like an ornament, Anything. Anything you can think of. A little stuffed toy they would probably love, especially the ladies. So, you can start now, and I'll put the threads up in the next couple of months, but if you're wondering, yes, we are doing the Senior Love Along again this year. And then I also wanted to mention, it's not solidified yet. We're still collaborating and deciding on all the details, but I am going to be doing another cowl, and this is with a C, so it's going to be, we've already decided it will be crafty, so sewing, knitting, crocheting, any kind of craft, but it's going to be stripes. Anything stripes. It can be self-striping yarn, it could be stripes because you have you're using different color yarns, but whatever you're making has to have stripes. And we are going to start on June 1st, and those are the only things I know for certain. That, and we are going to create a separate Ravelry group for this cowl, and the way I'm, maybe, who knows, maybe it will be something we do every year. But we're still collaborating and solidifying the details, but I just wanted to give you a heads up. So if you're thinking of casting on something stripey or making something stripey and you want to be a part of this cowl, we're leaning towards not including whips. So you might want to hold off and wait until June 1st to start that project. There will be prizes. We've all agreed that each one of us has to come up with one or two prizes, so there will be prizes, and yeah, I just wanted to give you the heads up about that, and when I know more, you will know more. When you had some time, I figured it'd be cool to think about what you want to do, and this way, if you were going to start something, you can kind of hold on to it until June 1st, so it can be part of that cowl, and you could possibly win a prize. So I'm gonna just like chill out here for a little while and relax and knit. And then when I get to the car, I have the Apple Blossem shawl and a new cast on. I know, like we're doing the whips cowl and I cast on new stuff, the two sweaters that I showed you when I was up on the mountain still, and a new shawl, Stephen West Exploration Station shawl, which would probably count for the stripey cowl, but I already started it, so oh well for that. But I do have an idea of what I'm going to knit for the stripey cowl, besides self-striping socks, which I have tons of self-striping sock yarn. I was thinking the something stripe mitts in the Mason-Dixon knitters put out this. Well, they didn't put it out, but I bought it through them, and it's a technique book that's coming out one pattern at a time. Then the first technique was helical stripes. I can't remember off the top of my head, but when I officially announce this, Cal, I'll show you what I plan on doing, and it will be it. So think about your stripey knitting, and I think that's going to be it until I see you to show you the last two whips. All right, I'll see you guys back at the car. Okay, so I'm at the waterfall that I podcast from last week. Let me just show you. Almost to the end of this trail/road, You could hear the main road up ahead. And I just wanted to record this because I told you last week I came here and I wanted to do this particular trail and I got lost. And when I was here last week, I had read about this trail. One of the things it mentions as a landmark is you'll cross a creek with a wooden bridge over it. And here it is for real, but this one is like right next to Seven Lakes Drive. So the other trail also had a wooden bridge, which I had recorded, and I will put a little, I'll put that clip in here. So I thought I was on the right track, and it says shortly after that you should reach the main, the road, and then you just have to walk up the road to the parking lot. So these are why, like, it's just if you're hiking alone, especially like I was, and I was like kind of too confident. Even if you do your homework, you really have to be careful of where you're going. And I just wanted to point that out. So here's the bridge. Here's the stream that waterfall falls into. Isn't that beautiful? And that's Seven Lakes Drive up there. And I'll see you at the car. So I tried to find a good spot by the lake, but I don't have my tripod with me, so I only have this little teeny stand for my camera, my phone camera. So I'm sitting in the picnic area on a picnic bench, and before I leave the park, I figure I'd show you my last two whips that I worked on, especially the Apple Blossem shawl, which I worked on a lot. Which is so big that it is now in my awesome granny bag. Sweater size, awesome granny bag. Yeah, so here it is. I really feel like I'm gonna run out of yarn. I still have another stitch pattern to do around. So let me find the marker. Progress keeper, okay, here's the progress keeper. So if you look here, let me spread these out a little. It's hard. It's pretty bunched up. Last time I showed this to you, I was here. And I basically completed the, it's called Little Butterfly, she calls this stitch pattern, which is lace, and it's just little V's with some cable twists. And right now I am in a 12 row, what she calls the garden path, which is stockinette, and then I have a border to do, which is I think it's at least 8 to 10 rounds. I'm not sure, I don't have the lace chart with me, but I want to get this done before next weekend because I'm going upstate to my parents' house that weekend for my sister's birthday dinner. And my mom's house is the only house that I could go to that has enough floor space to block something this big out on. It's where I blocked my Event Horizon shawl. And I need to block it up there. So if I don't block, if I don't get it done, which I will make a point to do, unless something big gets in the way. I would have to wait until I go up there again, which will not be till the beginning of May, to block it. And basically the only room in her house, well, her living room has enough room, but she has pets, so they'd be walking all over it. But in her bedroom, I usually block it out in her bedroom. Big things like this. So that has been the main focus of my knitting for the past 2 weeks. But I also was jonesing after our little trip to visit Stephen West, I was jonesing to cast on Exploration Station, so I did. Just to give me a little excitement in my life. So here are the colors. Let me show you the colors. I did post it on Instagram a few weeks ago. They're all Spirit Trail Fiberworks Sunna. And I have so much in my stash. I'm so glad that I'm putting it to good use. So this is Glacier. Sunna is silk, merino, and cashmere. Yes, and 15% cashmere. It's the best sock yarn, by the way, I've ever used. And I think it's because of the silk. And it's super wash merino. So I do wash my socks that I made in Sunna. But anyway, this is Glacier. It's a beautiful blue. This one's called Harvest. And it's got little speckles of like pink and fuchsia and like almost like a orangey color in there. This is called Smashed Raspberries, and this is All Natural, which is basically undyed. And I'm ready to start with the Smashed Raspberries for the next wedge. And this is all I've done so far. Like I said, I just needed to get to do some of it so that I could get a little diversion from the Apple Blossem shawl. But the next wedge will be the raspberry, smashed raspberries. And I can't wait to see what it looks like once I get all the colors going. So I'm sure I'm going to try to at least have one more wedge done for you before the next podcast. Again, it's Stephen West Exploration Station. And it's on Spirit Trail Fiberworks Sunna. And I think it's my favorite yarn. I think it's safe to say it's my favorite yarn. Yeah, so I'll be podcasting next. Actually, I'll probably be home, but I don't know where. I thought I was going to be upstate, but no, that's next weekend, and so I won't be podcasting next weekend. It's actually a little early for me because it's Friday, and usually I don't record until Sunday and usually get it up around Tuesday uploaded. So thanks for taking this little trail hike around Silvermine Lake with me. This place has a lot of really good memories for me. And it was really cool to finally make it around the lake. I hope you can get good use out of some of my tips about hiking. And don't ever hike alone, even though I just did. You really shouldn't. And especially on a trail you don't know, or a trail that doesn't have a lot of people on it. I was alone for like the entire second half of the trail. So if I had gotten hurt, but I mean, I just have to. So anyway, I'm gonna say goodbye for now. I will get this up and edited, and thank you all for taking the time to watch me. And if you are celebrating the Holy Week, I hope you have a blessed time with you and your family. And I will see you in a couple of weeks. Ciao for now.